I'm going to show you four surprisingly simple techniques that will help you make restaurant quality stir fries at home, and I'll demonstrate them all together at the end of this video on the Chinese American classic Kung Pao chicken. So the first one is ingredient sizing. Cooking time is a function of the starting temperature, thickness of your ingredients, and the cooking heat. So if you have two things that you want cooked to the same temperature throughout, and the diameter of one is smaller than the other, and you cook them for the same amount of time, the thinner one will finish cooking more quickly. So let's go through how to prep some common stir-fry ingredients so they cook perfectly every time. Minces will cook the fastest and work well for aromatics like ginger, garlic, and scallion. Matchsticks are another good shape and work really well for carrots, ginger, bell peppers, and potatoes. To get matchsticks, first cut your edges off and get a rectangular shape. Then cut into 1 or 2 inch sections depending on how long you want the matchstick to be. Cut lengthwise slices, stack them up, and cut them again into matchsticks. The process is the same for ginger and potatoes, but for bell peppers, start by cutting in a circular motion to get everything except the top and bottom of the pepper. Next, cut sections off and shape it into a rectangle and cut your sticks. Coins are a simpler shape, but cook equally well and are perfect for ginger, garlic, and carrots. To get coins, simply prep your ingredient of choice and cut thin, circular slices. Cucumbers have a lot of water in their core, so to prep these, cut off their ends and cut them in half lengthwise. Then with a spoon, scoop out the soft center and cut them into slices. This makes sure that we don't increase the water content too high while we're stir-frying and steam our ingredients, which is how you get a mushy end result. To prep leeks, give them a good rinse to make sure there's no sand or dirt in the inner layers, then remove the top and bottom and cut in half lengthwise. Then make a diagonal cut for the length of the leek. This will result in a diamond shape that looks good and cooks very well. Eggplants work best as matchsticks or cut on the diagonal. And for meats like chicken and pork, we either want small cubes or thin slices. It's helpful to thin out a chicken breast or a pork cutlet with a meat mallet before you cut it to guarantee evenness in all your cuts. Now that we know how to prep our ingredients, we can tackle our second technique, which is cooking on high heat. Stir fries come to life at really high heats, and you've probably seen a lot of recipes that say, add some oil into a scorching hot wok, or in a ripping hot wok, or screaming crazy hot wok. This is in part because high heat scorches the ingredients in a way that brings out their aromas and keeps vegetables crisp while searing protein so they don't lose all their moisture and become dry, while at the same time allowing for cooking things quickly so they don't steam. You may not have a huge burner available to you, but whatever you are using, make sure you get your pan or wok as hot as you can at the start of the stir fry before you add cold oil and then your ingredients. If you have a hot enough burner, you can achieve the elusive wok hei, or breath of the wok, which comes from the intense caramelization and essentially vaporization of the oil in the wok. Ideally, you want to be cooking on super high heat the entire time, so you don't risk steaming any of the ingredients. And if you're asking, how do you not burn the whole thing, that's where our third technique comes in, batching. This is essentially making sure you don't crowd the wok with too many ingredients at one time. If you put too many things in the wok at once, you risk dropping its temperature drastically, which can lead to uneven cooking of the ingredients. This is especially important if you're working with a stovetop burner or a pan that doesn't retain a lot of heat. You'll get a knack for the proper batch size once you try it out a few times, but this makes a huge difference with vegetables especially. Because of their high water content, they risk getting steamed and becoming mushy, so batching things helps keep them crisp. Our final technique is called velveting. Since we're using such high heat to cook our stir fries, we need a way to protect our proteins from overcooking or becoming tough and dried out. To do this, we're going to create a protective layer around the meat using a combination of egg whites, cornstarch, and a water-based liquid like soy sauce, Shaoxing wine, or plain water. To get an even coating and ensure the velveting mixture sticks, there are two steps. Get any excess moisture out of the protein before applying this mixture to make sure it sticks well, and par cooking it in boiling water or hot oil to get an even coating. To use oil, heat about 2 cups in a wok and pass your velveted proteins through in batches, cooking for about 15 to 30 seconds per batch. For water, the process is the same, but it might take slightly longer to par cook. This results in a juicier, more tender protein than if it was just stir-fried naked. So let's put all these techniques together and make some Kung Pao chicken. We're going to start by giving color to some ginger and arbol chilies, and infuse our cooking oil. Pull these out just before they're burnt and set them aside. Then add your minced garlic and fry them until they take on a little bit of color. Once the garlic is browned, remove it from the wok along with the oil, and then give the wok a clean wipe down. Next, we're going to stir fry our velveted proteins in 2 batches. We want to get a little bit of color on these and some char. Don't worry too much about cooking them all the way through since we've already par cooked them once and we're going to stir to combine at the end. Crank up the heat and keep the ingredients moving to prevent any steaming. You can see some splashing oil making its way into the bowl of the wok and catching on fire here, which will add some complex flavors in the form of wok hay, which really gives it the signature restaurant flavor. Next, we'll stir fry our vegetables, which shouldn't take more than 30 seconds or so. And then combine all the ingredients. Add a cornstarch slurry to thicken it up a bit, and finally our sauce. We want to add the sauce around the edges of the wok, which are extra hot, and add some caramelization that you wouldn't get if you just poured it into the center because of the extreme heat of the pan. This is another one of those restaurant tricks that can really make a difference compared to a normal homemade dish. Turn off your burner and you're ready to serve. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to the channel, and if you like this burner or want to check it out, I've put a link in the description below. See you guys next time.